This program will illustrate how the gram stain procedure is able to distinguish gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria by representing the staining events at the ultrastructural level. This particular animation is one of two in this series, showing the staining of gram-positive bacteria, with critical structures of the bacterial surface represented schematically. The circle at the lower right tracks how the bacteria would appear in the microscope if they were examined during each step of the staining procedure. Prior to staining, the bacteria would be transparent and invisible in the microscope. After heat fixing the slide, it is first flooded with crystal violet for 1 minute and then washed. The stain colors the bacterial cell wall blue, and the bacteria would appear blue in the microscope if examined at this point in the procedure. Next, the slide is flooded with iodine solution for 1 minute and then washed again. During this step, the iodine and crystal violet combine to form a larger complex within the layers of the cell wall. Microscopically, the bacteria would appear dark blue or black after this step. The slide is now rinsed with a decolorizing agent, an acetone alcohol solution. However, the crystal violet iodine complexes are not washed out of the thick and tortuous layers of the gram-positive cell wall, and the organisms remain dark blue in color. Finally, the slide is counterstained with neutral red or safranin for 1 minute and then washed again. The red stain also confers color to the bacteria. However, the red color is not apparent because of the persistent dark blue stain that dominates the microscopic appearance of the bacteria. So, by virtue of the complex, multi-layer structure of the gram-positive cell wall, these bacteria appear dark blue or black in the microscope after this staining procedure.